Hey everybody, hope you're having a good day wherever you're at, whatever you're doing. In this unit, we're going to talk about skin disorders. Specifically, we're going to focus on occupational skin disorders or skin diseases or ailments that can develop in the workplace. And what we see on the screen here is a great introductory example of what we want to prevent as safety professionals, as industrial hygienists. This is an individual who was exposed to plaster of Paris. They had plaster of Paris get on their skin. They were working in the sun. The interaction between the ultraviolet radiation of the sun and the chemicals in the plaster of Paris resulted in this severe condition. This is about as bad as you're going to see in the workplace. Now, a couple of mistakes the worker made. He should have been wearing a shirt. Other precautions that might have helped is, if possible, have some kind of shading in place. But again, these are the types of disorders that can occur in the workplace with contact to different chemical substances. Now, we're not just going to focus on chemical hazards that affect the skin. We're also going to talk about mechanical and physical hazards that can affect the skin also. Again, normally the mechanical hazards, that's not the domain of industrial hygiene. But from a practical standpoint, as safety managers, we need to consider any of the hazards that can affect the skin. As I'll talk more about here in just a second, the skin is the organ of the body that in some ways is at the greatest risk, because it's that front line of defense. It's the first thing exposed to many of the workplace hazards that we're going to come into contact with. And I mentioned the photocontact dermatitis, or the interaction between the sunlight and the gypsum. The term for that is photocontact dermatitis, a skin disorder caused by contact with chemicals and subsequent exposure to sunlight. Now, not all chemicals are going to result in this type of skin disorder, but some chemicals are activated by the ultraviolet radiation and sunlight. One of the chemicals that will result in photocontact dermatitis would be gypsum-based compounds. I already mentioned the worker was working with plaster of Paris, which is a gypsum-based, fast-drying liquid material that's used. It's used for a lot of different reasons, but this particular worker was constructing these decorative moldings like we see in the picture here. If you go into an upscale home that has these elaborate moldings, there's a very good chance that those moldings were constructed from plaster of Paris, which again is gypsum based. But let's go ahead and talk a little bit more about why we should be focused on the skin as safety professionals. It is the largest organ of the body. It's part of the integumentary system. It has several functions that it performs for the organism, for us as organisms. Most of these functions are protective. They protect us from bacterial or viral infection, ultraviolet radiation, impact resistance. Yeah, we don't think about the skin providing impact resistance, but the skin along with the fat layer under the skin does provide impact resistance. The skin allows us to absorb certain vital nutrients. It's involved in vitamin D synthesis, temperature regulation, the excretion of waste. We produce waste. We take in liquids and foods, and we have waste materials that have to be excreted. The skin is involved with that process. When we sweat, we are excreting waste materials from the body. Touch reception and pain reception and our warning system. It's part of our warning system that tells us when we are in danger. Our skin, because of the pain receptors in the skin, will warn us that we need to move our hand away from that hot stove, or we need to find shade because we've been out in the sun too long and it's become painful. And also, say a little bit more about this. I've already mentioned this, but it's worth mentioning it again. Why is it important to focus on the skin? It's the largest organ. Because it's the largest organ, it is there's a great deal of exposure to hazards in the workplace. Hazardous chemicals, physical hazards, ultraviolet radiation, as we'll see, is one of the greatest hazards to skin. Not only a hazard to our skin, but our hazard to our overall health. But skin is that first line of exposure to a lot of different hazards. We can absorb chemicals through the skin. Our skin itself can be affected when those chemicals or other hazards make contact with the skin. It gets overlooked a lot, I think, in many workplaces, but it is essential that we focus just as much attention on protecting the skin as we do any of the other organ systems in the body. Just a quick rundown of the major anatomical structures that make up the skin. Three primary layers: the epidermis, the dermis, and the hypodermis. Epidermis is that outside layer, the dermis is the middle layer, and the hypodermis is the deepest layer of the skin. These three primary layers of skin include sweat glands and pores that are involved in temperature regulation and the excretion of waste. Our hair follicles are found within the three layers of skin. These contribute to our sense of touch. They also perform a protective function. Sebaceous glands lubricate the skin, help to keep it from drying out, help to keep it supple. Their nerves and nerve endings, which of course are involved with the sense of pain and our sense of touch. Keratin is the protein that forms the skin cells. It's the same protein that also forms hair and our nails, our fingernails and our toenails. Here's some other views of the different layers of skin. In epidermis, the stratum corneum, a thin layer of dead skin cells provides a protective armor. It's a lower layer of living cells. The dermis, the network of woven keratin, microscopic blood vessels, provides additional protection. Then our hypodermis, that deepest layer of our skin, includes the sweat glands, blood vessels, hair follicles, fat tissue that provides protection against impact and stores energy. Now, there is a video that I'm not going to show you. If anybody would like access to the video, I'd be happy to share it with you. But it's just more information about the layers of the skin. And like I said when I talked about the respiratory system, we don't have to be medical doctors when it comes to anatomy. We do need to be familiar with some of the terms, but we don't have to have a medical doctor level of knowledge of human anatomy to work as a safety professional, even to work as an industrial hygienist. One thing interesting about the skin: all three layers combined are about 4/100ths of an inch thick. So these three layers and all of these structures are combined into a thickness of about 1 millimeter, or 1/1000ths of a meter. 4/100ths of an inch, 1/1000ths of a meter. We have all of these different structures that we're talking about. We have the epidermis, the stratum corneum, the dermis with all the blood vessels. We have the sweat glands, the hair follicles, all of that within a very, very thin cross section. I thought you might find this interesting. You may have heard this before. It may freak some of you out a little bit. We all serve as a host to millions of microscopic organisms. One of those microscopic organisms in particular is a skin mite. This is a magnified view of what is living on our skin and in our pores. And most are harmless. We all have them. There are multiple species of skin mites, and they do perform functions for our health. They destroy harmful bacteria. They remove dead skin. Some of these mites would feed on our dead skin and feed on those harmful bacteria, or otherwise destroy those harmful bacteria. So they do perform a function. Again, we shouldn't freak out over it, but if we were to take a microscopic look at our skin and in our pores, there are some skin mites that are taking residence inside of a pore. We see the hair coming out of that opening. It looks like four skin mites are taking residence in there. I thought you might find that interesting. If you want to freak out your significant other, you might share this information about skin mites with them. Well, how can the skin be injured in the workplace? We're going to talk in more detail about skin disorders and skin diseases in the next lecture, but I do want to talk about the different mechanisms by which skin can be injured or diseased in the workplace. And there's more than maybe you realize. So let's just quick run through this list of different ways that our skin can be damaged or develop disease. There's the mechanical, physical hazards, like sharp edges, of course. The cold. We can develop frostbite, which we'll talk more about later in the semester when we talk about thermal stress. There can be burns. Also, we'll talk more about that when we talk about thermal stress later in the semester. Impacts. There can be impact types of injuries to the skin. Friction or abrasion, as our skin surfaces come into contact with other surfaces. Prolonged contact with moisture. If our feet, our hands, or other body part has prolonged contact with moisture, this is what can occur. It's called maceration. Let me go ahead and pull that my text box up here. Maceration, prolonged contact with moisture. And most of the time it's not going to be serious, but it can become serious. If corrective measures are not taken soon enough, and if it becomes infected, if we end up with open wounds and it becomes infected, certainly it could be life-threatening at that point. But these are some of the mechanical or physical dangers that can affect the skin. We also have the chemical hazards, of course. Direct chemical exposure can result in chemical burns or lesions. There can be a chemical reaction like we saw with the photocontact dermatitis. You know, photosensitivity, photocontact dermatitis. There, some people, depending on the medications that they're taking, may be more susceptible to skin disease. Some medications especially may make them especially sensitive to sunlight. And when they're especially sensitive to sunlight, that can manifest itself in different skin disorders. Absorption through the skin could result in systemic intoxication, or the systemic effects that we've talked about in previous units. Absorb the chemicals through the skin, gets into the bloodstream, affects other organ systems. Now, the chemicals that can harm the skin can come in a variety of forms. It could be chemical vapors. Some chemical vapors can result in skin irritation or disorder, skin disorders. Contact with liquids or contact with dust. Depending on the chemical, different states of matter for that chemical can have effects on the skin. So it's not just liquids, it's not just vapors, it's not just dust or fumes or any of the other states of matter. It can be all of the different states of matter that a chemical can be in that can potentially affect the health of the worker and result in skin disorders. non-ionizing radiation, ultraviolet light from the sun. I'm going to talk a lot more about this. I think it's maybe one of the most overlooked and one of the most dangerous workplace environmental hazards we have. Lasers in the workplace. Many workplaces utilize lasers to perform different functions. Welding also is a form of non-ionizing radiation that can cause damage to the skin and the eyes especially. Ionizing radiation. When we talk about ionizing radiation, we're talking about radioactive elements. There are some industries where workers may come into contact with radioactive elements and ionizing radiation. And what's going on with ionizing radiation? We talk more about this in the second industrial hygiene class, but ionizing radiation basically rips us apart at the cellular level. At the atomic level, I said cellular level, actually at the atomic level, there is a stripping of that structure. There's a damage to that structure at that atomic level with ionizing radiation. Now, industries where there may be exposure to ionizing radiation, the medical industry is probably the number one. Aviation industry, also there's a higher level of exposure to ionizing radiation. Depending on where the work is taking place, the construction industry or the mining industry might have a higher exposure to ionizing radiation, to radioactive elements. There are different test procedures and test instruments that utilize radioactive elements. Of course, we have x-rays that are used in the medical industry, the healthcare industry, but x-rays are also used for testing and inspection in other industries as well. So if you're in one of those industries where x-rays are used or where there may be other exposure to radioactive elements, that would be high on your list. High on your list of things to focus on as a safety manager. And we'll spend an entire unit on ionizing radiation in the next industrial hygiene class. Then there's a whole list of biological exposures that can occur. Certainly bacteria, viruses can result in different skin disorders, and that's what we see going on over here. Go ahead and bring the text box up. This is a fungal infection, better known as ringworm. Ringworm is not really a worm, it's a fungus. But we have fungal infection. You know, fungus is a biological organism, bacteria, viruses, a wide variety of parasites, toxic plants, and toxic animals. And we'll talk a little about each of these as we look at specific skin disorders that we have to be aware of as a safety professional. All right, that's it for this introduction to skin disorder video. In the next video, we'll go into more detail looking at workplace-related skin disorders and diseases.